We did say we would push the issue for stronger laws against rape, which are being seen by an increasingly large number of people as the only solution now. And we will take that issue up once again on News Hour tonight. I am delighted to have another Times Now viewer, Dharmesh Jhaveri. Let me shake your hand. And Mr. Jhaveri, thank you for coming. And let me also say this
right on
the start, that I am delighted that the Times Now viewer is on the Times Now panel. And I want to say this to all viewers, some of the best points in our debates, in some few sessions we've had, especially on these Friday evening sessions, have come from our viewers. So it's good to see you, Mr. Jhaveri.
Thanks.
Ashweta Parulekar, spokesperson of the Shiv Sena, is with me in the studio. Justice Mukul Mudgal, former Chief Justice of the Punjab and Haryana High Court from Delhi. Sudha Ramalingam, advocate and vice president of the PUCL from Chennai. National Secretary of the Bharatiya Janata Party, Vani Tripathi, is there from our studios in Delhi. And my first question is to Shri Anupam Kher, who joins us, needs no introduction, one of India's best actors. Mr. Anupam Kher, you know, we've had this debate on the death penalty, softer laws. We've had a serious discussion on why we cannot have the system of castration as there is in many developed countries, including the United States of America. Can this debate now be brushed aside, or will our lawmakers have to take this debate seriously and reconsider the existing laws, which many people believe are treating rapists with kid gloves? Mr. Kher.
Absolutely, Arnab. We need to do that. And we need to do that, and we need to keep on protesting till that law is brought in. Because, and I hope that this continues, this agitation, this outcry, this disastrous that has struck at this moment, I think it should go on. We should have the most horrific punishment for a rapist. It's not only a rape of a body, it's also a rape of a mind of a girl. It takes away, it is the most brutal thing that can be subjected to a lady or to a woman. And I think there's only an emotional response to this kind of a thing. You cannot have a logical response, you cannot have a sane response, or you cannot have a kind of response which said, but law should take its own course. I'm sorry, I don't adhere to something like that philosophy at all. Because I react as a father, as a brother, as a son, and all the people who react to it, who are agitated or who are so horrified, are somewhere reacting like that. And I think it's important that castration, public flogging, I'm going to say, and I know I don't care if people start calling me a Hindu fundamentalist for saying something like this. It has to be something. So there is a fear of punishment in anybody who is even thinking about it. It's not the question of only this 23-year-old girl. It's
yes.
happening all over the place. 3-year-old girls are being raped.
Yes.
6-year-old girl, her father used to make her drink, and then friends used to rape. The rape is become a such an ordinary kind of a crime,
yes.
in terms in public, or for lawmakers,
yes.
or for politicians. I think they should come together, call an absolute emergency parliament session, and when other laws can be passed, I'm sure all the MPs in this case will pass a law like that, death sentence for a rape.
The problem is there is a human rights lobby which will begin to protest. And Sudha Ramalingam, my question.
I think this. I think. Arnab, to that, I want to say, if human rights is defending it, then it can't be called human rights at all. It's inhuman rights.
Correct.
You agree with that?
Of course, human right is to protect human beings. Simple. It's a very fine, simple definition. Why the intricacies? Why the complications of defining a human right?
You second that, Shweta Parulekar.
Absolutely.
It should be.
Do you feel the existing laws look at justice more from the point of view of the perpetrator of the crime
100%.
Than the victim of the crime?
Than the victim of the crime. So as Anupam ji rightly said, if the human rights people are going to protest or oppose this, that is really sad, because it is all about taking care of the victim, who is a human finally. So it is definitely not going to be liked.
Absolutely. Before I take the issue to Justice Mudgal, I'd like to get in Sudha Ramalingam. Sudha Ramalingam, today in India, any act of sexual assault should be treated on par with attempt to murder. Hence, Section 307 of the IPC should be amended. One. Second, you should have gradations. Chemical castration is one option which has been seriously considered and is being practiced in the United States of America. And for heinous serial rapists, death penalty. Even as a human rights activist, I'm sure you'll support us on these two grounds.
Kindly let me speak. With great respect to each and every one in the panel and all of those who have been raising their voice for death penalty, I would like to repeatedly state that we are against death penalty for any offense whatsoever. The reasons are this. We have great sympathy for the victims. We do not want any crime to happen. But having said that, I would like to state that the very, very philosophy or jurisprudence behind any punishment is to reform. To eye for an eye will only make the whole world blind. Killing a rapist is not going to deter anyone.
Okay,
Secondly, if you have death penalty as a penalty for... Kindly let me talk. If you have death penalty as a sentence, the proof would be much high and it will be sure that many of these rapists would go scot-free than when you have life or 10 years as the punishment as it is there. The law is not faulty. What is really at fault is the execution. We do not have
second,
a proper
executive
mechanism.
Sudha Ramalingam, you are presenting a standard argument against death penalty. You will present the same argument against death penalty
you
in any context. But however,
argument.
Let me ask you a follow-up question. Don't get angry. I'm only asking a question. I'm asking a question.
No, you are only presenting a knee-jerk reaction.
No, it's not a knee-jerk reaction.
I think media should go above knee-jerk reactions. We'll have to be rational. We'll have to be rational, logical, and legal. We should uphold the rule of law. We should not be upholding a rule of masses.
One minute, please.
This is not the manner in which we...
1 minute. I just want to tell you two things, Ms. Sudha Ramalingam. If you say no, first of all, whatever you say applies in any context. Secondly, the people who have done this to the girl are not humans. They're animals. So I am a little worried and concerned at this whole human rights argument, which is it's a you know what it is, Ms. Ramalingam? It's a standard photocopied human rights argument which is applied regardless of context. Let us not forget the context of this case. I want to get in Justice Mudgal. Justice Mudgal, my question
I'm
to you is this.
I'm as much worried and concerned as you are. But I would not be willing to do a knee-jerk reaction to any particular situation.
Yes.
Let us be logical. Let's all totally apply
can I ask
law.
You a question from Sudhaji, please?
You want to ask a question? Okay, go ahead. Then I'll go to Justice Mudgal and Vani after that. Yeah.
And I'm asking you with utmost respect for womanhood of Sudhaji and respect for every woman. Has Sudhaji's ever relative been raped? Or has anybody made an attempt of rape towards her? Has her daughter been raped?
Let's not go beyond the point.
You don't need to die to talk about death. You don't need to die to talk about death. We do
but
know what rape is.
It's ironical that a lady is raising her voice and saying about another young girl that this punishment should not, and it's a knee-jerk reaction. It is not a knee-jerk reaction, Ms. Sudha. How can it be a knee-jerk reaction? I know that you are doing your job as a human rights advocate or whatever you are. I know that you are doing a job, but you have an agenda.
Okay,
you're not talking
second.
From your emotion,
no,
you're not talking from your being a woman. You are talking as some member of some committee or something like that.
Wherein we got two consecutive life sentences, wherein the life sentence was given two consecutively
you
without
see,
any remission.
You see, I'll
and
tell you one thing.
Prema died in prison.
One second.
You know? So
I have a question.
Life sentence, life should
I
be
I want
life.
To go to Justice Mudgal. Justice Mudgal, my question to you is, about the certainty of punishment versus the severity of punishment. One argument is that given the number of rape accused to walk free due to some loophole in the system, will the certainty of punishment and not the severity of it be a bigger deterrent to anyone who thinks of crime as a heinous as rape? Therefore, we have two issues. Certainty of punishment versus severity of punishment.
Your question itself gives the answer. The certainty of punishment expeditious trial, quick investigation, and recording of witness statements under Section 164 on oath. Because what happens is, when a rape trial is prolonged, the woman gives up, the witnesses turn hostile because they haven't recorded their statement on oath. So I would say that certainty of punishment, the expeditious punishment is the need of the hour. Forensic investigation should be improved. Secondly, I fully understand the revulsion which has been caused by this gruesome incident, and I appreciate the emotion and the sentiments. But the punishment is, life is possible in gang rape. In fact, if there were five persons involved, even if two indulged in rape, all five are equally guilty and can be awarded and should be awarded life punishment.